I'm TV, I'm Alicia Fernandez. Well, in today's episode of Gems of Goa, we have with us a person who is a youngster from Sharao. We have with us Joash Mendonca, who is the International Umpire for Table Tennis Federation, which is a distinction of one of its kind. And this is the first time a Goan has achieved it. So congratulations, first of all, and welcome to the show.
Thank you, Alicia. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me on the show.
So, Josh, tell us, how does the entire feeling, has it sinked in till now after you cracked the exam? And, like, what is it like? How is it going?
To be honest, like, it was very difficult for me to digest the fact that I made it, and that too in my very first attempt. Because, to be honest, like, it's very tough to get it in the first attempt. But, and it was something that was spontaneous. Like, it was not something planned a couple of years back. It just happened this year, and I decided to give it a try, and I went for it. So the satisfaction that came in was amazing, and especially being the first Goan to achieve the feat was a feeling that I can't really describe. I was on top of the world.
So, but then, like, how did it all start for you? Like, when did you realize that, you know, you wanted to do this, and, you know, you wanted to get into this? So when exactly you received that, you know, this is it, I need to do this now?
So basically, I love traveling also. So I was a certified national umpire a couple of years back. But back then, I never really thought about taking it seriously. So what happened was, this year, there was a notification had come from Table Tennis Federation of India saying that an umpire is required for the nationals being conducted at Jammu Kashmir. And I received the notification. And I solely accepted the notification only because the place was Jammu Kashmir and I had never been there. So the purpose of it was travel. Of course, umpiring was a part of it, but the main purpose was the travel, like to traveling Jammu. So then that is where I interacted with a lot of seniors, and they guided me saying, there is no international umpire from Goa. The rest of India is doing pretty well. Why don't you give it a shot since you're taking this seriously? So that is when I started thinking about it, and they told me that the umpire is this year, so it's conducted every 2 years. So that is when I took it seriously and I said I should give it a shot.
So when exactly this entire exam happened to you? Was it during the lockdown or was it before that?
So actually the exam was under normal circumstances, it was supposed to be held in April. But usually it's a 3-day training followed by the exam. They call it any one center in India, depending on where the highest number of people have registered from. But this year, due to lockdown, it became pretty difficult. Like, the date kept on postponing. And finally, they decided to have the exam online and without training or anything. So that was a bit tricky. So yeah, I answered my exam in June ending. And it was an online exam. I had to sit home and answer.
Wow, and I think the results came very quickly, if I'm not mistaken, right? The results were out right just around last week or something?
Yeah, actually the results was out the very same day the exam was released. But by the time I got my certificate and all, so the certificate made by the ITTF took some time. So that after I received the certificate, that is when the news went viral. So, yeah, that was last week.
So, how exactly that thing is going on right now? Like you said, the news went viral. How is, like, everybody reacting to it? How is people's reactions? How are they responding to this particular news?
It has been crazy, actually, because and handling such type of things is something new to me. Like, I've never really made it to the papers before, so everywhere I go, people are like, I saw you on the paper, it's the same person. And friends posting stories, the Instagram was filled with the newspaper cuttings, Facebook, you name any social media, it was viral. So it was really a happy feeling, but something I'm really new to. So yeah, handling all of it was something I enjoyed doing.
So, it's like, what were the major challenges that you came across? Like, you know, everyone has a set of challenges that they had to deal with. Like you said, that there were no training and you had to go in for the exam directly. So, what were the major challenges according to you and the entire lockdown phase had postponed the exam to June. So it was like a good time for you to make sure that, you know, you had enough time to study, or like what exactly was the major challenges for you?
So, like I said before, I was the first born to answer this exam. So being the first born, I know I didn't have proper guidance. Like I didn't have any seniors who could guide me. So I had to get all my guidance from the other states, and that was online. Like I didn't have somebody to guide me how to prepare for the exam. I had no backing up absolutely. So even if I asked somebody, they would be like, I'm sorry, I don't know. You can ask somebody from the other state. So getting everything constantly from the other states and not having a senior here was something like I was always scared that I may not crack the exam. So that was one of the biggest challenges, not having a senior to guide you. And like everything had to be done on my own. But I was very fortunate. I had a sir named Lenny Rosario from Margao. His son is the top, like the number one ranked table tennis player of Goa. So he had some knowledge, so he guided me. And also the training part, like usually in the training they teach you like how to, you know, give time for the exam, how to like time the exam, how to answer, which questions to attempt, which questions to skip. So without that training, answering the exam was tricky. So these are the few challenges. Yeah. So these were the challenges I faced. And like I said, for me the plus point was I got extra time to study with the lockdown. So I made full use of that.
Well, indeed. Well, on that note, we're going to take a short break. On the other side of the break, we still have Joash Mendonca, and we are going to speak to him more about his journey, and keep watching Prime TV.
This is Info Media Prime Slot Network, and you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. We're in conversation with Joash Mendonca, who's the first international umpire for the Table Tennis Federation, and from Goa, he's the first one. So first of all, tell us about how was the journey of, I think you were a very passionate table tennis player, right? So how did, like, you know, you said like, you know, I need to pursue in this, and I want to, like, you know, leave back table tennis, but I will be there part of table tennis.
So I started my journey in the fifth standard when I entered high school, and it was a coincidence. I never really knew table tennis as a sport. I just happened to enter the games room and people were playing, so I decided to give it a shot. And then I just fell in love with the game, and then there was no stopping. Then fast forward 10th standard, that was when I did my first nationals. I went. It was my first trip outside Goa, so that was another happy moment. Then came high secondary and college, and that is when I had to make a call whether I really want to continue with the sport, or, like, you know, after college everybody has work pressure and all that. So I decided to stop playing and I started working. So I was working for Decathlon Sports India, so that was a sports company, and I was working for table tennis. I was handling table tennis for that company. So that was like, I was still continuing with table tennis. And then after the notification came, that is when I thought, like, okay, so there is a new dimension to it. If I can't play, at least I can be in the sport by like umpiring. And that also gave me an opportunity to go for a lot of nationals. So I was getting traveling, I was getting my passion sport, I was getting table tennis, I was getting everything. So I said it is a very good option, and that is why I started taking it up seriously.
So then how do you, like, you know, right now, as you said, like, you're balancing between the two. So how do you ensure that, you know, it is like balanced in a very good way, be it your, you know, work and this field as well, sports field? Because a lot of people give more importance to work sometimes, and some people give more importance to sports. So how to strive a balance between the two?
So a good thing for me is I was working for a sports company like Decathlon, and it was table tennis, and something that I'm very passionate about. And when you're passionate about something, that is when you don't think about any work pressure, you're enjoying all of it. So sometimes working extra, it was all fun. So I never felt work as work. It was always fun, and like the people around me also were all sports lovers. So when everyone has a like mind, it's a very fun environment. Like I never
it's like basically you continue speaking about sports more at work.
Correct. It is just sports all around me. So, and sports is something I'm very, very passionate about. I can't even explain.
So, do you think that needs to be more facilities when it comes to, giving training to umpires in Goa so that, you know, they too in future may take up this particular thing? What needs to be done as per you?
Yes, definitely. Like, awareness is one of the main things. Like, in Goa, everybody is going flat towards playing. Nobody knows that there's a career towards in umpiring as well. So, I feel more of awareness, like more people should come up. I mean, table tennis is still a developing sport in Goa. Not many people have taken it up. Not many people know about table tennis. But slowly, the growth is happening. Like, the changes are happening.
I think there has been a huge change though, how it was earlier and now. Now, it is catching up.
It is catching up. So, we have a few ranked players who are ranked in India as well. Like I said, Vestigo Rosario, then. A couple of years back, there was Tennessee Kitteni. So, we have players coming up and table tennis is growing and so is the awareness. So, it will take time, but awareness is one of the key features and that is what we all need to focus on. Like, more and more people should know about the sport and more people should know that there is a career in umpiring.
Exactly. So, I think in this entire thing, when it comes to children deciding that they want to do something like that, parents play a very important role. So, how important do you feel is the support of parents? Like, for you, in your case also, maybe how is it like, you know, in your case, when you said like, you know, you wanted to do something in this?
So, yeah, parent support plays a very important role. Like, whenever I wanted to go for nationals, especially now in the later stages, it always used to be a solo travel. Like, there was nobody else, there was no team, nothing, and I had to travel solo. Like I said, even Jammu Kashmir was a solo trip. And the doubts are always there in the parents, like, my son is going to Jammu, what will be the, like, we know the political situation there. So, yeah, like, the parents' confidence is definitely, it motivates you. So, a parent backing you up when you're really interested about something is very important. So, the parents should motivate you. And that is when you can go with your whole heart, not having a second thought about anything, because you know that no matter what, your parents have your back. So, parents backing is very important.
Also, if you go to see, there's a lot of thing wherein they, it has been said with the sports marks, these all add up to the student's holistic, the holistic perspective of a student when it comes to, you know, exams and your sports marks together. So, sports also play an important role. But when it comes to a full-fledged career, a lot of people are, you know, taken aback and saying that maybe you may not be able to pursue a full-fledged career into this. You can do it as a sports, but not as a full-fledged career. So, what do you suggest? Like, what needs to be done more from our side, from the government side, to ensure that, you know, this thing needs to be motivated, encouraged to the people?
So, I have been reading about this a lot because, even when I wanted to make a career, I had second thoughts about it. So, the problem with the Indian system is we wait for somebody to get famous and then we, support the person. Like, normally a person needs support when he's just starting off, not when he's already famous. Because once he's already famous, that's already because of his hard work and all of that sort. But when he's at the grassroots level, nobody knows about him, nobody's supporting him. And that is where we lose most of the good players. Most of the players don't have finances and they are not really able to grow. So, if at that level you can identify talent and promote talent, that is something I would really, like to see.
So, now that, you have already achieved this distinction of international umpire, so what are your future plans right now? Like, what are the things which are coming up for you?
So, first I need to get an international tournament, you need to have a very good reputation in India. And how you get that is by constantly going for nationals and having a very good performance. So, the people who get to go for international tournaments are the people who have a very good performance in India. So, once my performance in India is good, that is when the Table Tennis Federation of India will recommend my name for international tournament. So, So that's the plan now, going for more and more nationals and
national.
You know, like, having a very good performance so that my name is recommended for international tournaments.
Well, we wish you all the very best. We are going to slip into another short break. On the other side of the break, we still have Joash Mendonca, and we are talking to him more about his journey. So stay tuned. We will be right back.
This is Info Media Prime Slot Network. And you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back to my conversation with Joash Mendonca in our last and final part of this particular episode. Joash, if I may ask you one more question with regard to your entire sportsman spirit. How important is sportsman spirit for youngsters nowadays to understand that you may win, you may lose, but you need to continue playing? How important is that?
So when you're in sports, you really need a lot of mental strength, especially when it comes to table tennis, because you know it's a very fluctuating game. And like in sports, everyone knows somebody has to win, somebody has to lose. But the fighting spirit should never end. I mean, there will be a lot of downs, especially like even in my career, there were a lot of downs. Like before I won the first gold medal for the state, like for my school, there were 7-8 years where we never won anything, and then suddenly there was a high. So you need to be persistent, like you need to train hard, you need to know what your goals are, you need to focus on those goals, and if you continuously work towards them, then success will definitely come. Like there's no stopping. So you need to have a goal, and you need to be goal oriented and focus towards that. And if you're persistent, consistent, success will definitely come your way. So you need to have that fighting spirit. You need to be a true sportsman. You need to never give up and always go for your goal.
Well, as you said, right now what we're going to do is we're going to head towards the rapid fire round. This is the particular segment which a lot of people wait in our show. So let me begin with the rapid fire round. So are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, brace yourself as we begin. Your favorite sports idol?
Lionel Messi.
Okay, your favorite holiday destination?
I'm not very sure, but I love going to waterfalls. So, Goa itself, but I love going to any waterfall, trekking.
Okay, your favorite thing on this planet?
Table tennis.
Okay, fill one word for the following. Okay, fill one word for the following. Table tennis is?
Nostalgia.
Okay, as a youth you were?
Playful.
Okay, if not an umpire?
Player.
Okay, if you woke up as the following people? World number one for table tennis.
I'm not very sure. But
what would you do if you woke up as those?
I'm not very sure. It would be an amazing feeling. I don't know. It's just a dream.
Okay. So if you woke up as a sports minister?
Like I would focus a lot more on the graphic development. Like I said, I would have something figured out on how to develop the graphic talents and how to discover talents at a very young age. That would be the main focus.
Okay, if you woke up as the stand-up comedian Kapil Sharma?
Gonna probably make fun of people and of table tennis and make it funny so that people get to know more and more, like on a national platform, what better way than to promote table tennis on such a big screen.
Okay, and if you woke up as me?
Sorry?
And if you woke up as me?
I would definitely take interviews of more and more table tennis players. So, you know, back to TV or whatever, it's filled with interviews.
Well, I think you did a wonderful job in your meet and rapid fire round. So now, before you leave, I want you to give a message to all our audience and everybody watching this particular episode. Go ahead.
So I would like to tell everybody that always believe in yourself, always take risk in life, whatever goals you have, always go for it wholeheartedly. Either go for it wholeheartedly or don't go at all. There's nothing in between. And if you really love something, always strive for it. I know it may not come immediately, but somewhere down the line, it is definitely written for you. And if you go all out for it, success will definitely come your way. So I would like to say, never give up on your goals and always give it your best shot. That's it.
Well, that was wonderful. Thank you so much for taking time off and talking to us, Jayesh. It was amazing having you on the show.
Thank you so much for having me on the show. Had a good time.
Yes, on that note, this is the end of this particular episode of Gems of Goa. We will be back with many more stars in future of Gems of Goa. So keep watching your favorite channel, Prime. Keep watching Gems of Goa.